Isn't this awesome, guys? Our school has got a very awesome swimming pool.
Yeah, I know. That way we won't have to wait till summer. We could just go swimming every week until the school year ends.
Let's not forget, they also got a sauna available for us and the other middle schoolers. I think that would be kind of awesome too.
Yeah, I agree, Zach. The swimming pool here is the bomb.
Hey, look. There's Anne Bunshui and her frog, Sprig Planter.
Hey you guys, so, what do you think of that new indoor pool they opened not that long ago?
I'm going to be honest with you, Anne. I think it looks very nice, especially that my friends and I are going to take swimming class every week since we got signed up.
Well, that's great to hear, Lincoln.
Hey Anne, I was wondering if you could be my swim buddy for swimming class for now. I kinda wish your friends, Marcy and Sasha, would join in with us.
Now that you mentioned it, Sprig, yes, I can be your swimming buddy.
Excellent, thanks Anne.
You're welcome, Sprig.
Oh, not to interrupt your conversation, but I think the new student is coming to see the pool too.
Yeah, he should be here anytime now.
A new student? Wow, that's so great to hear. I hope he'll also like the pool as well. Anyways, we're gonna continue our recess time. We'll see you at swimming class later on.
Okay, see you later on.
Well, looks like Anne and her frog is coming to our swimming class in the afternoon. I wonder how Sprague's swimming style will be like once he's in the pool.
Yeah, I agree with you, Liam. I also wonder if he's going to do other tricks in the pool, even though he is an amphibian frog.
Hey, Lincoln. Now that Sprig is going to be Anne's swimming partner, maybe one day you can let Lana's pet frog, Hops, be your swimming partner soon, if that's okay with you.
You know what, Clyde? That can be a good idea. I'll think about it soon.
Speaking of that, here he comes now.
Greetings, friends. I'm Christian McLean. I come from Canada. Oh, hello Lincoln, Clyde, and everyone here.
Hello, Christian. Well, you just made it to Royal Woods, Michigan, because that's where we attend school here.
It's good to have you here, Christian. Because we know that you like Thomas and Friends, as well as a few other baby shows. Even though we all have our opinions on some of them.
That's okay, Zach. It's just a personal opinion. And say, come to think of it, that pool they opened up not that long ago looks nice, since my parents signed me up for swimming class.
That's awesome. Since you're good friends of us, you get to join in as well.
Yeah, Lincoln is right about that. Say, how about you come outside with us? We'll let you meet the others, and I'm sure you will get along with them pretty well.
Yeah, they won't bite you. So, let's go.
Wow, Ronnie Ann. Look at this new pool that they opened. It looks really nice.
I know, Sid. The both of us besties would become swim buddies when we will sign up for the swimming class.
Hey, Ronnie. Hey, Sid.
Hi, Lincoln. Hi, Christian.
I see that the two of you are making compliments about this pool.
I know. It's so spacious. Right, Sid?
Yeah. I bet we could swim like mermaids. And pretending we're in the deep blue sea.
You know, I can imagine that myself as a mermaid too, just like Ariel from The Little Mermaid. But I really do hope that you girls can join us for swim class.
Not to worry, Christian. Me and Sid will always know the buddy system while swimming.
Well, our swimming class starts in next few hours. So, we will see you guys there when our last classes are over.
Okay, Lincoln. We'll see you guys there.
Hey boys, I just came here to check, because after swimming class is over, I'm ordering Domino's pizza for everybody. Normally I wouldn't allow food in the pool due to some people getting stomach cramps, but, you guys can eat in the home EC room. I also added a big screen television in there, where y'all can watch movies or play the PlayStation 2, and some Bluetooth speakers if you all wanted to hear some music.
That sounds awesome, Bobby. I hope you could order some drinks to go with it, like Pepsi, Mountain Dew, and other sodas.
Not to worry, Lincoln. I will order plenty of drinks for everybody.
Hey, Bobby. I was wondering, do they have Hawaiian-style pizza at Domino's? Because even though I'm Canadian.
You are correct, Christian. Yes, they do have what you like, and I will also add that to my order as well. Oh, would you look at the time? Well, better head out of the locker room fast.
We're right behind you, Bobby.
Okay, students, welcome to your first day of swimming class. I am Wendy Corduroy, and I'll be your swimming teacher and your swim coach from here on. Now, I'm going to take attendance. When I call your name, let me know that you guys are here. Lincoln Loud.
Here.
Ronnie and Santiago.
Here.
Clyde McBride.
Here.
Liam Honeycutt.
Here.
Zach Girdle.
Here.
Okay, class. You have at least an hour and 30 minutes of swimming. Please do enjoy yourselves while Bobby is on lifeguard duty. If anyone is at risk of drowning, please call me out if anyone needs help. And please, for your safety, no running around and no fighting near the pool. Now, before we get started, are there any questions? Yes, Lincoln.
Is it all right if I can do a cannonball?
Sure, I don't mind. Just make sure you do it by the deep end of the pool, as long as you don't splash anyone. Anyways, have fun and enjoy your time with each other.
Hey, Lincoln. Now that we are at the deep end, let's do our cannonballs in the pool.
Yeah, let's do it. Cannonball. Come on, Lynn. The water is fine.
Right behind you, bro. I'm number one. Hey, bro. How did I do?
I must say, your diving was really impressive.
This is so great, Amity. I'm glad that this school built this indoor pool here.
Yeah, you said it. That way, we don't have to wait until summertime, because summer is a long way to go.
Yeah, you're absolutely right about that.
Hey, Ann, are you ready to take a dip in the pool?
I sure am, Sprague. Let's go.
Hey, bro. Are you up for a swimming race? I want to see if you can try to beat me.
Sure thing. Since you have been practicing me on how to swim, we'll race together.
That sounds like fun. Let's do it.
Hey, Lincoln and Lynn. We just heard that you guys are doing a swimming race. Can we watch y'all face each other?
Sure you all can. It's just a friendly competition, so yeah, why not?
Excellent. Let's see whoever can make it to the other end wins the race.
On your mark. Get set. Go.
And the winner is Lincoln Loud.
Lincoln, you won. You really won. Congratulations, bro.
Thanks, LJ. I'm quite fast from learning all of the swimming lessons you taught me.
Now, Lincoln, we never knew you swam so fast. That's amazing.
I know cricket. Since my older sister is athletic, I too am a good swimmer. Oh, hey, Bobby. I didn't know you were going to swim with us.
So, Bobby, are you on your break already?
Well, I'm glad you guys asked. It's because Wendy let me be the guard of the pool for today, and making sure everyone is cool, so I get to swim with all of you guys. And besides, it's always best to hang out with buddies, just like you guys. My little sister, Ronnie Ann, Lincoln, and your sister, Lynn Jr.
You're absolutely right, Bobby, because Lincoln and I are swim buddies. Just like the rest of the others.
Well, Lincoln, I was wondering if you can race me, just like when you beaten Lynn.
Sure thing, Bobby. I accept your challenge.
This is definitely the life right here. Am I correct, Liam?
Yes, you, Zach. I bet if I brought my pig Virginia to the pool with me sometimes, she would make a good swim buddy.
I have to agree with all of you. That's why swimming class is so much fun than the other subjects in this school. This is way fun than playing dodgeball.
Marco.
Polo. I love playing Marco Polo. It is a fun game to play in the pool. Am I right, CJ?
Yes, Carl. You are absolutely right about that. As much as I like playing sharks and minnows, just like in that episode, Slink or Swim.
Right. That's when Bobby taught me how to swim, when I was having my fear of trying something different for once. But now I'm able to swim like a fish.
Hey, Carl. Hey, CJ.
Oh, hey, Clyde.
Mind if I join in with you guys? Because I want to play sharks and minnows too. How about I'm going to be the shark, and you and CJ are the minnows?
Sounds like a great idea, Clyde. So, what about Liam?
Oh, Liam was just swimming by. Here he comes now.
Hey, fellas. Since you guys mentioned about playing sharks and minnows, I want to be one of the minnows too, if that's okay with Clyde. So, shall we begin?
Okay, let's do this.
Man, going underwater is so much fun, especially when we're acting like mermaids.
Yeah. My frog friend is an amphibian, since he's a frog that swims.
Yeah, I think I learned about it in Mr. Bolhoffner's science class, since they do breathe underwater just like a fish.
You know, Mabel, my sister Adelaide happens to be quite fond of frogs, even though she has an array of pets.
Yeah, just like Lincoln's little sister, Lana, who also trained my pet bunny, Jazzy.
You know, Stella, I might even bring my pet Lalo to the pool sometimes, even though he is a big mastiff that can be very excited, but I'm sure he'll love the water as well.
That's nice to hear, Ronnie N.
Anyways, do you guys want to continue our fun underwater?
Sure, I'm up for some more. Let's do it.
Are you serious right now? I can't believe these idiots got assigned for swimming class, and not me. Me and the rest of the troublemakers get detention and not this class? This is so stupid, and so unpredictable. I wish they never built that stupid pool in the first place. This school still be normal.
Chandler, we heard everything you said. Do you know exactly why we didn't assign you to swimming class? It's because we don't allow and trust troublemakers like you who do all of those bad things.
And it was my idea to build the pool in the school, because the principals accepted it. Now, march back to detention right now.
Yummy. Nothing but some good old Domino's. It's twice as good as Little Caesars.
Yeah, you said it. I heard most recently they made those loaded tots.
Wow, Bobby. Compared to what I ordered from Little Caesars for my sleepover before, Domino's is not that bad to me.
It's like what they say, Zach. You just have to order it right away and avoid the noid.
You're right, Bobby. This reminds me of that one angry video game nerd episode, which is the Pepsi Man, who happens to be the Japanese mascot of our favorite beverage.
Well, now you said it, Rusty. Man, it's a good thing Bobby ordered us some good old pepperoni pizza for all of us.
Hey, LJ. How are you liking that pizza?
Well, after you and I swam so much, this pepperoni pizza is top-notch.
Good for you, Lynn. I can't get enough of the good old Hawaiian style, which I know Anne doesn't like pineapples on her pizza.
You are right, Christian. I'm usually against having pineapple on pizza. At least Sprig can eat pizza without his hands, but only when he eats with his tongue.
You know, I think I am now good at eating from my hands, but sometimes I can think of myself like Frogger and Yoshi when eating stuff without my froggy hands.
Yeah. Although you're a frog, you do have a cool ability to use your tongue like Frogger, you know, the Kalnami arcade game.
Yeah, I know what you're saying, Bobby.
Man, it sure was great to have Mac as my swim buddy.
Yeah, Blue, you said it. Even though you are not a big troublemaker like Chandler, along with the others like Classic Kalu, but I'm glad that you managed to be my swimming pal. But anyways, how are you enjoying that pizza?
Pretty good, Mac. It's a good thing I watched you swim very well, even with Becky, from the Casa Grande days. Good thing she didn't cause any trouble just like Chandler.
Yes, Blue. I decided to behave myself for today, since I have already signed up for this class.
That's great to hear, Becky. At least you are not a very bad person like that red-headed jerk, Chandler. At least he didn't cause trouble for us today.
Yes, Ronnie-Ann, you are absolutely right about that.
Wow. Just like the pizza we eat at Great Lakes, that way we don't need the bogus delivery fee.
Yeah, you said it. Anyways, how are you enjoying Domino's, guys?
You know, Sid, this pizza is still top-notch. Better than having Papa John's, Pizza Hut, and Little Caesars, in my opinion.
Say, guys, as a country boy myself living in big city man, from where I live, there's not many pizza places these days, but thank goodness we could avoid the noid with Domino's.
You know, guys, I wish we can do this more often. Whenever we finish our swimming class, we can hang out and eat with each other.
Yeah, I agree with you, Stella. That would be a great idea.
Hey, you guys, me and Bobby are very glad that all of you enjoyed the first day of swimming class. It was so great of me being the teacher there for now. We can't wait to see y'all again tomorrow, because Marina, from Zig and Sharko, will become our underwater guard duty.
Really? Marina the mermaid? That's so excellent to hear, Wendy, and I can't wait to see her tomorrow.
What? You have got to be kidding me. They get to have pizza after swimming class? How is this flipping possible? Man, I wish I was in the class, instead of going to stupid detention, and I wish I can get to have my own pizza, but, how am I going to do that? I got it. Tomorrow afternoon, I'll just sneak into swimming class. And I know just how to do it. I'm going to replace Lincoln Lame, and bothering all of the students in the class. Chandler, you are genius. Ha 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 ha. I can't wait to see the looks on their faces tomorrow.
Wait a minute. Did I just see Chandler in the hallway? I think he just mentioned about someone to kidnap, and replacing one of the students for swimming class. I don't know. Something just doesn't seem right with him. Maybe he is just talking some junk. Oh well, at least I can go home to my island. Because tomorrow, I am on underwater duty for swimming class.
Well, looks like I got everything planned for today. Just got to make sure I have my swim trunks with me. Good, now, it's time to get down to business.
Hey guys, ready for another day for swimming?
You bet we are, Lincoln. Yesterday was fun. We can't wait to go back in the pool again with the others.
Well, let's finish up our class time, then we'll be ready for our second day to our swimming class.
Okay, it looks like everyone is here, but where's Lincoln?
He is probably having a long walk from Mr. Bohlhoffner's trailer. Who knows, I'm sure he'll make it here.
Man, finally, I made it. That was a stupid long walk from my teacher's trailer. Well, at least I'm here, and I get to go to my swimming class again. Now it's time for me to change.
Not today, Lincoln Lame. Ha 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 ha. I got you in my sights now.
Hey, Chandler, what are you doing? Get off of me.
Never. It's time for my payback once again. Perfect. Now that I got my revenge on you, I get to take over your spot in your precious swimming class.
You will never get away with this. Untie me now.
I would love to, but I got some fun to attend and some pizza to eat. So long, Lincoln Lame. Ha 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 ha.
Guys, Lincoln is supposed to be here.
Yeah, he is going to miss out the fun.
What's up, losers? Hello, Wendy.
What the? Chandler? What is he doing here?
Yeah, you are not even qualified for this class. As a matter of fact, where is Lincoln? He is in this class too.
Oh, about that. Lincoln is having extended time with Mr. Ballhofnor, due to his missing homework. So, Principal Ramirez and Miss Clementine said I can take his place.
What? That's impossible. Lincoln never miss any homework assignments. I know my brother very well, and he's my hard-working little bro. Ugh, it's probably just one little assignment. Well, it could have been worse.
Ugh, fine. You can join in. Just don't cause any trouble, please.
Yes. Finally, I get to have fun swimming. Oh yes, this is the best day of my life. No one can spoil my fun now.
Man, this class cannot be fun without Lincoln.
Yeah, I know, Zach. But how does he even get to stay at Mr. Ballhofner's class all because he missed his homework? He could have at least give Lincoln a one little warning.
That is so impossible. How did the principals even accept this red-haired jerk in this class? Like, seriously, he's a troublemaker for crying out loud.
I still don't trust him. Something smells like a rotten fish in a can, just like Sir Stramming.
Well, I'm sure it's just one homework, because you're right, Stella. He never missed anything whenever it comes being in school.
Yeah, that's correct, Clyde.
Say, now that we wait for Lincoln, how about we do some flips underwater?
Okay, sounds good. Let's get in the pool now.
Hello, this is Lincoln Loud. Sorry I can't get to the phone. Please leave a message after the beep.
Hey Lincoln, it's Ronnie Ann. I'm just calling to see if you're okay. I hope you will make it here soon as possible. See you. Well, Lincoln didn't answer his phone. He is probably still in Mr. Bullhoffner's class.
Yeah, maybe his phone is on silent, or on vibrate. But I'm sure he'll be here soon. Shall we get in the pool?
Sure, let's go.
Hello, guys.
Oh, hello, Marina.
I was just checking to see how you guys are doing, because I am on underwater duty. Is everything okay?
Yeah, we're doing okay. We just hope that Lincoln will make here soon.
Don't worry, Mac. I'm sure Lincoln will be here soon as possible. Look on the bright side. At least this class will end at 4 o'clock.
Well, looks like our little Lincoln has plenty of time to make it here. I'm sure he'll be okay.
What's up, losers? Having fun without Lincoln? Well, boo-hoo. Mr. Ballhofner kept him for the rest of the day, and he's alone with no friends, stuck doing his missing work. Poor little loser he is.
Hey, that's not nice. Lincoln is not a loser. He is a kind kid that we love and support. Unlike you.
Yeah. How rude of you.
You are very, very lucky to take over his spot, but we don't want nothing to do with you. So, beat it.
Or else, I'm going to beat you.
Hold on, Anne. I know how you feel, but there's no fighting in swimming class. Fighting never solve anything. Just let this disrespectful child enjoy his time here. Me, Wendy, and Bobby will keep a sharp eye on him.
Enjoy your time, Lincoln Lame supporters. Ha 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 ha.
Man, that no good Chandler never learn.
Tell me about it. I still despise him with a burning passion.
Anyways, let me go back to do my job. I'm going to check the other students to see if they are fine.
Okay, Marina. See you later.
Hey, I'm starting to love this swimming class so far, and they even have some pool accessories I can play with. And would you look at that? They even added the Superman and Batman toys. I'm going to play with them now. Yes, I am so enjoying this. In your face, Lincoln Lame. Ha 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 ha.
Hey Marina, how is your underwater job going?
It's going good, Wendy. Thanks for asking.
That's great to hear. Now that Lincoln will show up a few minutes late, due to his missing homework for Mr. Bullhoffner's class, We just have to keep an eye on Chandler, in case he causes trouble here.
Wait a second, Wendy. Lincoln already told me that he finished what he got to do yesterday. There's no way he can be replaced for this class.
Wait, what? What do you mean?
What Chandler said to you guys when he got to this class. I don't think it's true. Maybe he is trying to make up an excuse and did something bad to Lincoln.
I just realized something. I spotted Chandler in the hallway yesterday. I heard that he was planning something to sneak to this class and trying to kidnap and replacing Lincoln.
Oh no, this can't be good. We have got to find him pronto. Let's start looking around the locker room.
You're right, Bobby. Let's go find him.
Help me. Somebody, help me please.
Oh my God. Lincoln, don't worry. We're gonna save you now. Hold still, you are going to be okay. There, all done.
Hey Lincoln, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Thanks Wendy, Bobby, and Marina.
You're welcome, Lincoln. Anyways, what happened? Did Chandler really did this to you?
Yes, he did. I made it here right on time for my second day of swimming class, and Chandler came out of nowhere from behind, took me down and tied me up on the locker room bench.
Oh my gosh. That's horrible.
And, I think he made up his own reason on why did he replace me for that class, right?
Yes, you are right. He did plan his excuse to us of him being here.
We're so sorry, Lincoln. We're sorry for falling for his trick. We thought we believed him, but now, he has lied to all of us.
I'm sorry too. I should have kept a closer eye on him yesterday, because he was planning all of this to you. I thought he was complaining and talking smack because of his jealousy not being in that class, and I should have reminded you in the first place. Again, I'm so sorry, Lincoln.
It's okay, Marina. I forgive you, and I forgive you too, Wendy and Bobby. And it's nobody's fault for believing in Chandler's words. I accept all of your apologies.
Thanks, Lincoln. We're glad that you forgive us.
Hey, no problem. It's great to have all of my supporters like you guys.
Anyways, it's time to end Chandler's fun right now.
That's him. That's the jerk who kidnapped me and taking over my spot here.
What, Lincoln? What are you talking about? I thought you were coming from Mr. Baalhofner's class.
Don't even think about lying to our faces now. We found Lincoln tied up in the locker room, and he told me what happened.
And he already finished his classwork for the teacher. Now, what do you have to say about all of this? Well, I just wanted to be in this class to have some fun.
By trying to kidnap and replace me? Finding someone to be the victim? No, I don't think so. You had your precious little fun, and now it's time we end it for good.
You better change to your regular clothes right this instant when we take you to the locker room, and tell all of this to the principal. I will be watching you.
And, Marina, make sure you keep Lincoln safe while we deal with this.
Okay, guys. I got this.
Come on, Chandler. Let's go. Right now.
Chandler, are you serious right now? How dare you kidnap Lincoln, and how dare you sneak to his spot for swimming class? We will never allow kidnapping in this school from our books. Unlike what you did to Ronnie, Anne, and Sid before, do you know how bad he could have suffered while being tied up?
I want to go to swimming class. I want to go to swimming class.
No, we never wanted to sign you up, because we do not allow troublemakers in swimming class. That class is only for good students, so, you better explain why you did this.
Okay, fine. The reason why I did this because I didn't get signed up, and saw them having pizza after class. That's why I got so jealous and kidnapped Lincoln for that. And, how did you let my friend Becky in the class? That's so not fair.
Because, she doesn't cause no crazy harms like you do here, and she is nothing like you. We gave her one day of that class every week. Her grades were average, and we accepted it.
Speaking of that, since you explained on why did you kidnapped and replaced Lincoln to be in swimming class, you will be serving in school suspension for 5 months, and, since you love the pool very much, you will be the pool cleaner, every afternoon along with your 5-month suspension.
I want to swim, not clean.
Too bad. You should have never kidnapped and replaced a victim over a class you wanted. That's so bad.
We're going to inform your parents about this, because that is so unacceptable for what you did. Bobby and Wendy, escort this boy to detention, because he'll be getting out until 7 p.m.
Got it. Come on, Chandler, let's go.
Welcome back to detention, Chandler. You will be staying here until 7 p.m. for what you did to my favorite student. We don't ever, and I mean never, allow kidnapping in here and replacing someone to be in a class you really wanted with jealousy. You should have gotten used to not being signed up for swimming class, but no, you did what you had to do to get yourself in a lot of trouble.
And, as your punishment, you will be taking a 100-page assignment, and you're going to clean up our pool until closing time. You got a lot of work to do.
Hey Lincoln, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Man, we were so worried about you. Did Chandler hurt you?
No. He just started grabbing me and tying me up. I just can't believe he did this. All because he wants to be in this class.
Man, he still never learned his lesson. We are so sorry that Chandler kidnapped you.
Yeah, and taking over your spot for this class.
And we're so sorry for falling for his tricks. We thought you stayed in Mr. Bullhoffner's class for a missing assignment.
It's okay, everyone. It's nobody's fault that you guys fell for him, and I don't blame none of you. And plus, I've been finished with my teacher's assignment, and he gave me a good grade for it. But, sometimes, he is still a jerk, not like Chandler. I just don't feel comfortable being in his class with that red-haired lunatic.
Hey Lincoln. I understood. But, sometimes, you just have to accept what they gave you. And, if you don't like it, there's always some ways to solve your problem, and we can help you, and helping out each other.
Yeah, you're right about that, Marina.
But, the most important thing is that you're still okay, and you're safe with all of us. And, we hope that this will never happen again.
We know that you don't deserve any of this from Chandler. You deserve better than that, and be treated with respect.
If there's anything or anybody that is bothering you, we will help you out. And we will solve your problem, because we will always love and always support you to the end.
And, if you think that you can handle things on your own without our help, that's okay with us. But, just make sure you make the right decision and make sure you're being safe.
Yeah. If someone is hurting you, you know I got your back, because you are my brother, and it's also my job to look after you. Remember that.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for all of your supporting advice that you guys are giving me. I know I can count on all of you.
You're welcome, Lincoln. That's what friends are for.
Hey, Lincoln. You can change into your swimming outfit now, because we're going to extend our time for this class since you are already here.
You'll do that. Thanks, Marina. I'm going to change now. There, all done.
Say, now that you are here, how about we do a swimming race again, and this time, all of us?
Sure, Lynn. I like the sound of that. Doing a swimming race with all of you sounds like fun.
And, Lincoln, now that already dealt with Chandler, we're thinking about taking you and others to McDonald's after this class. Sounds cool?
It sure does. Thanks, Bobby and Wendy. And thank you for saving my life, along with Marina.
You're welcome, Lincoln. We're just doing our job.
Anyways, now that Lincoln is finally here, let's continue to have some more fun.
Yeah, let's go.
Chandler,
Are you serious right now? How dare you kidnap and replace Lincoln, all because you wanted to be in swimming class?
We don't ever kidnap and replace someone over a class you wanted, because that will make you feel very cold and heartless, and making you feel very dumb for what you did. Why did you do this? Explain.
Because I saw them having pizza after class, and I was jealous.
And you deserve it, for being a spoiled little troublemaking brat. That's it. You are grounded for 10 months, along with your ISS, and your punishment for being a pool cleaner. Now get your troublemaking butt upstairs to your room now and think about what you have done today, you red-headed jerk of a son.
This is the worst day of my life.
Welcome everyone to our lesson of the day. The moral of the story is, never come to a class that you weren't signed up for. If you don't want the current class you're assigned to, you can just ask your teacher, or your principal instead.
Kidnapping and replacing someone, or a classmate, is never the answer in life. Those kinds of class that you're assigned to can be part of your grade to pass, and boosting your GPA. Rather, it's in school, college, or other workplaces.
When you get someone caught for doing something bad, you can also get rewarded.
And last but not least, please don't make an excuse or telling a lie for your mistakes, because it's very important to learn from them in life.
Well, that is it for our lesson of the day. Please take care of yourselves, make better choices, and please be safe. This is Clink on McCloud Plush Channel, signing off.